Hello, welcome to how to build your own network storage server with Raspberry Pi. With this method you will have a low power and very compact network storage server, great for personal or small office needs. Let's get started. I have a mini computer and a traditional hard drive. You can use a solid state drive if you want. I use a traditional hard drive to optimize the capacity. First you install an operating system on it. I connect the memory card to the computer. I use Open Media Vault to build the network storage server. I follow the steps as instructed. You format a memory card before installing the operating system on it. After completing the format, you go to the step of writing the image file to the memory card. There are quite a few versions of operating systems that can run on mini computers. Following the instructions, I downloaded the compact version. This version does not have a graphical interface. It only has a command line interface. The advantage of it is that it consumes less resources more. Thank you. You set up the device name, username, password and enable remote access for the mini computer before writing the image file to the memory card. Then you wait a few minutes to complete. After completing, you connect the memory card to the mini computer. You connect the mini computer to your network system. Your router will assign it an unused IP address. You use an IP address scanner software or access the router management page to know the IP address of the device. I access the router management page to find the IP address that the router has assigned to it. After knowing the IP address of the device, you open the command window on the computer. Here you connect remotely to the device using the command prompt. You use the username and password set in the previous step to access remotely. Before turning the device into a network storage server, you update and upgrade the operating system. Next, you just copy and paste the script command. You will have to wait quite a while to complete this step. It took me about 30 minutes to complete it. After it is done, the device will automatically reboot and you will lose connection to it. You use any browser and access the network storage server using the IP address. So I have completed the operating system installation for the device. Now the basic steps to create shared folders over the network. I connect a traditional hard drive to the device using an adapter. You can connect multiple hard drives to the device if you want. In this example, I only use a single hard drive. After the device has detected the hard drive you just connected to, you format it. Next, I create a new user and use it to access the shared folders. Because I do not want to use the administrator account for remote access. That is not safe for the system. You create a new folder and share it. You name the new folder as you want. Don't forget to enable the sharing service. I use the service commonly used sharing service. Next, I add the newly created folder to the sharing service. Then you allow the newly created account to read and write on the newly shared folder. The basic setup steps are completed. I will access remotely to check the results. The above are the basic steps to build a low-cost network storage server. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Good luck. You can connect more hard drives to increase capacity if you want. I recommend you set up a static IP address for the device for a better experience.